Now, your KSBW weather forecast with meteorologist Gina DeVecchio.
For this first weekend of October, our morning temperatures have actually been feeling quite fall-like. Take a look at this, 39 degrees in Carmel Valley, 40 in King City, but near the coast, some 50-degree low temperatures. And tomorrow morning, I expect more upper 40s to 50s. So a little bit of a warming trend overnight, big warming trend for the afternoons. You probably noticed that today. Temperatures about 5, 10, even 15 degrees warmer in some locations. Up in the Santa Cruz Mountains, anywhere from mid-70s to mid-80s, 80 degrees in Capitola. Before the break, I mentioned Santa Cruz. The 4 o'clock temperature was 80 degrees for the high, but actually at 5 p.m. it got up to 82 degrees. Aptos, mid-70s, a pleasant day there. And look at all of these mid-80s. So not too hot in our inland spots, but unfortunately tomorrow, if you have anything to do outside, get out there early because these temperatures are going to soar. Looks like into the 90s for tomorrow afternoon for some of our hotter spots. Could even get close to 90 near the coast. Now, temperatures down the Salinas Valley did reach 90 in Gonzales, close to that in Soledad at 89. And look at that, 79 for Monterey earlier today. Many of these high temperatures of the mid-70s to upper 70s were late morning, early afternoon. Then around 1 o'clock, little sea breeze dropped those temperatures into the low 70s and the 60s. But overall, a nice evening. Look at that sunshine in Salinas. Yes, a little bit of a breeze coming in from the northwest, but temperatures overall mild. Look at that, 6 degrees warmer for Salinas, Monterey compared to last night. Ben Lomond, 9 degrees or 11 degrees warmer, many 9 degree warmer temperatures. So about 10 degrees warmer than yesterday at this time. Fantastic for the Saturday night. Hopefully you can enjoy these pleasant evening conditions. Look at all those 70s to 80s on the map. Now we do have a little bit of a breeze, relatively light. We are going to see that drop off tonight, and then looks like we are going to be seeing the big change tomorrow is that we have this ridge building in the area. We're also going to see a few clouds coming in. So this system from the south, so this is a warmer system, could bring some high clouds, but really not going to block the sun much, maybe a little bit at periods of the day. But for the most part, we're still dry. We're still going to start to see hotter temperatures for the afternoon. And then also we still have that red flag warning up towards the north. Christopher was mentioning that earlier, with the threat of some fire danger. We're not seeing that here because we're not as windy. In fact, we're having some pretty light winds. And then as we go into tomorrow, still going to be warm. You can see those clouds being pulled into the area for your Sunday. And then by Monday, that should clear out of here. And then by the middle of the week, we are going to start to cool a little bit. So if you like the refreshing starts, tomorrow's going to be another cool one. Not as cold. May have a little offshore breeze earlier, upper 40s to mid 50s with a mostly clear sky with those few high clouds. And there you can see on the map, more 50s. Than 40s, and I don't think we'll see those upper 30s. For tomorrow afternoon, we are going to see some mid-70s around the Monterey Peninsula, maybe even some low 80s and then low 90s for some of the hotter spots. So it is going to be another hot day. San Francisco Bay Area, look at all those 80s for the city down to Silicon Valley. Could reach 90 up in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Could also reach 90 in areas like Santa Cruz, perhaps Watsonville, Corralitos, even Prunedale today got in the mid-80s, and tomorrow looks like another day that it's going to be warm in those mid-80s. 90s possible for some of our hotter spots like Carmel Valley and down the Salinas Valley. Over the next few days, though, you notice a little cool down. Temperatures look to rebound at the end of the week, kind of up and down, hovering above average, then slightly below. And then we have some clouds increasing next weekend. We'll watch that. Some models are indicating some rain, but it is early in the season, so